Hey, I had a question come up on a YouTube comment, and I thought I would take a moment to answer it. So this is Jason Stone, and I've just been working with Logos users to see how they use the software. In one of the recent videos that we had, I had someone actually ask about the changes in the dynamic toolbar and where to find the interlinear, and then how to delete a reading plan. And so I'm just going to run through those and answer those for this individual, and then also post it to my channel in hopes that it might be helpful for others. So let's go with the reading plan first. So you're looking at Logos here. I'm going to close everything. You're looking at my Logos platform right here. And so where I would instinctively go to navigate my reading plans would be the documents. Looks like I was already working on it just to make sure that I had my bases covered. So I would go to the documents section on the either far left or the top of your application. You can go to the bottom here and enlarge that. I like to keep it minimized, so I have a lot of real estate to work in. But I will go to the documents. In this case, I will click and drag it and drop it here to open up so that we can see everything. There are these three lines at the top left. I call it a hamburger menu. It looks like a little hamburger. And then by selecting those three lines, I see all sorts of filter options along the left side here. So I'm going to go down to reading plan. And if I have it narrowed down to just a few reading plans that I've done in the past, it looks like this one here, Days on Light, is finished. So I'm going to click delete on this by right clicking on the reading plan and then clicking delete. And if you do this by accident, you could always navigate to the, I think it's called documents.logos.com, documents.logos.com. I'll put that in the description as well. I'll put the correct link in the description after I verify that it is the correct link. And you can actually pull it from your deleted files that way. But this is how you would delete a reading plan. And that's probably, I hope that's the answer to the question. Just clarify in the comments if that's not. And then the other question was around the new dynamic toolbar. So there's been a lot of changes in this section along the top. Logos is calling this the dynamic toolbar. So if I click on this, it looks like it hides. I can also navigate to different parts of the dynamic toolbar here to access different features across Logos' software. And the question was actually around the interlinear. And so you need a Bible that has interlinear or reverse interlinear capability. In this case, the ESV in my application does have that. And where this is found is actually, if you think about how you're viewing scripture, it would be found under the View tab, and then the interlinear section is found right here. One thing I did notice while working through this myself is if your pane is kind of like, let me close this out here. If your pane is a little bit smaller, I'm gonna just collapse this a little bit, then View is not, you can't see it. It's hidden under this More section here. So you'd want to stretch it out and make sure that View is enabled here. And then right here inside of View Interlinear, you've got your interlinear options here. So there's two ways that folks commonly use the interlinear. One would be the interlinear inline, and the other would be the pane along the bottom. And if you notice, there's actually shortcuts here. So there's keyboard shortcuts on Mac. There's this command, that's what that is, symbol. So you would click Command I or Shift Command R, and that would pop up the interlinears by keyboard shortcuts. But if I enable it, then I've got the, in this instance, I've got the reverse interlinear pane at the bottom here, or I could enable inline and select which parts of the RVI that we'd like to have displayed here. So I hope that's helpful. I hope that's what you were looking for when you asked about the reverse interlinear with the new dynamic toolbar update. So that's it. Short and sweet this week. Don't have an interview scheduled. So I've got three scheduled upcoming, but not one to drop today. So I thought it'd be a nice way to answer some questions. I'm always willing to do this. If you have any questions, ask in the comments, and I'll see if I can demonstrate how to make that happen for you. So alrighty. Thanks.